Welcome to Embedded System Design Lab. Today we are going to write embedded C program for performing serial communication using UART using the Kiel Microvision version 5 software. So today we are going to show how to use UART for serial communication in STM32 device series. And we are going to use UART for serial communication between the devices, since it's the easiest protocol where clock synchronization is not involved. In this experiment, I am using STM32F103 series device to generate the necessary code and then edit the code in Microvision Kiel 5 version. STM32F series have several hardware serial ports. Typically, there are at least 5 ports. So, before going to the experiment, let us see what is the basic behind serial communication and UART communication. Serial communication is a technique used to send the data bit by bit using transmitter TX and receiver RX signals between the devices. Both the devices will be synchronized by a common ground connection. This serial communication, there can be 3 modes of transmission, can be either simplex, half duplex or full duplex, depending upon whether it is one-way communication, two-way communication and whether data transfer is happening simultaneously or not in case of half duplex and full duplex modes. Once we have selected the data frame or the number of bits that we want to transfer, which is dependent upon whether we are performing serial communication or parallel communication. Serial communication, we are transferring the n bits of data one bit at a time, whereas in a parallel communication, we will be transferring 8 bit, 16, 32, 64 bit and so on. So, once we have selected the number of bits we want to transfer within a data frame, now the NDNS will take care how the data will be stored at the particular memory address. So, we have studied 2 types of NDNS, that is Little Indian System and Big Indian System, for storing the data at the particular memory addresses. So, when we have a binary number, for example 8 bit, and we are using a Little Indian System, the data will be read bitwise from LSB to the MSB, that is least significant bit to the most significant bit, and it will be stored bitwise in the memory addresses. And for a Little Indian System, the data binary data is read from the most significant bit to the least significant bit and stored bitwise in the memory addresses. This example figure here shows a complete packet for a serial communication taking place, wherein always starts with the start bit, which is going to help us to know that the transmission of data has begun, followed by your data frame. In this case, example is shown as a data frame of 8 bits, and the last bit indicating the parity bit, whether the data transferred within the frame is even parity or odd parity. The parity bit is set to 1 if at all the data transferred having even number of 1s in case of even parity, and the parity bit is set to 0 in case of odd parity, that is the number of 1s transferred within the frame is odd. This parity bit helps us in error checking the data transferred within the frame. After the parity bit, in a serial communication follows 1 or 2 stop bits which will indicate the transfer of the frame of the data being completed. Start bit, parity bit, data bit and stop bit of all these 4 parts make a 1 complete frame in serial communication. Next, which are the different parameters on which serial communication is going to perform? Baud rate, data length selection or data framing, synchronization and error checking. So these are the 4 parameters on which we are going to design or configure our serial communication header files. Baud rate is nothing but the speed at which the data is being transferred from the transmitter towards the receiver. Data framing is nothing but selection of number of bits or the length of the data to be transmitted within a frame. Once the data framing is done, we have to decide on the synchronization, that is the start and number of stop bits, and the data frame part followed by a parity, wherein, as already told, parity bits will perform error checking by means of even parity and odd parity check. Next is coming to basics of what is UART communication. UART, as we all know, is Universal Asynchronous Receiver Transmitter, wherein it is the simplest protocol for communication between serial communication between two devices asynchronously, that is, it is not synchronized by any external clock device. It's a simple computer hardware device for asynchronous serial communication, requiring only three basic wires, TX, RX and a ground. The TX wire of UART 1 will be connected to the RX of second device UART 2, where RX is the receiving point for the UART 2. For the two devices to be synchronized, both the grounds will be connected together in order to avoid data transfer or data mixing. So complete, this shows one packet using your serial communication as discussed in the previous slide. Next, let us see a few data about our device in target STM32F series. STM32F series is a medium density performance line. Its ranging pins from 36 to 100. This device is having about 4 to 16 megahertz range crystal oscillator, wherein we are using a crystal frequency of 8 megahertz in the configurable target settings. This is going to provide up till 8 communication interfaces. Out of these 3 UARTs, 3 UARTs in our case, we are going to see that the first UART will be clocked with full system clock frequency, whereas the second and the remaining UARTs will be clocked to the clock system frequency divided by 2. Some of the well-known applications of this include motor drives, inverters, printers and scanners, alarm systems, where the printers and scanners making use of parallel communication for transferring huge amount of data at a single stretch. Whereas advantage of serial communication over parallel communication is long distance communication of the data. The STM32 device has a fractional generator which is going to set the baud rate for the transmission around 11500 standard value. Each UART here has a register called UART BRR which is going to hold the divisor stored as 12.4 floating point unsigned, which is going to set us the specified standard baud rates. Now coming to the programming part. In this experiment for performing serial communication and checking the output in the serial windows in the keel, we are going to use the source code file which is already present in our keel arm development tool. The name of the project would be either hello or hello world or some such in an example path where your keel software is loaded. I can see here under keel 5 version, go to arm. In that I will be checking my examples which is containing all the different supportive files, inbuilt projects and simulators. Hello, I can see a folder which is going to have some supporting C files, header files and also few Microvision projects. I can see a project called Hello So I am trying to run or show the serial communication using this already existing project in the ARM development tool set. Coming to the programming, first I'll go to project, click on project, open project, open, go to the path showed recently, ARM examples, hello, open the MicroVision project, which would be saved as either hello.uvprog extension in the older versions of Keem. Open. So once you open the project, you can see STM32F103 device, which is being used to simulate serial communication in our experiment, and the supporting header files, C embedded program codes, and our hello.c, everything is targeted and projected in this hello path. Coming to the hello.c, this file, as I already told, is a part of MicroVision ARM development tool, which is used here to simulate the serial communication, and we are going to see how the serially the data is transmitted and checked in the serial window of our UART 1. We are also having startup file STM32FX, which is containing all the information about peripherals, memory mapping, interrupt vector tables. We are also having the different addresses of stack, heap, and all the other initializations necessary for the different registers. We also have a file called serial.c, which is going to perform initialization of the serial interface before beginning the serial communication. Coming to the program, we are including the header file for the device which you are using to simulate, followed by your stdio.h file for IO function prototyping. Next, we are calling ser_init serial interfacing initialization, which is a part of the serial.c. So we have given it as extern here to mention that this is present externally out of this hello.c program. I am using a some message within the while loop, while one transfer this. So it's an unending loop here, goes on printing the message or sending the data until the loop ends. So when I transfer welcome to embedded system lab serially, we see that internally the ASCII codes of the individual binary bits sent each time will be displayed indirectly to display the values sent. First bit W is being transferred, so the ASCII value of capital W will be transferred, so you can be able to see W on the serial window of UART. Please go through www.ascitable.com for ASCII values of all the special characters, alphabets, lowercase, uppercase, and different Indianness systems in the ascitable.com. Coming to the running of the program, first let us click on translate. With zero errors, now let me build the program. So I will see that now whatever are the errors or warnings will be visible in your build window. Assembling, compiling has started, and finally with zero errors I can see the message, go to red color debug start stop control F5, it will turn on the debugger, and once you run the debug, now you can see all the memory and serial windows on the UART windows opening, which will all the registers shown here contains all the different addresses. I want to see whatever the message I have transferred here to the serial window of UART. Go to view. You have to go to serial windows and go to UART 1. Now let me run the code. Go to project, debug, run, or directly you can go here, run F5. Next, I'll go now and check my serial window for the UART for the particular message. Similar fashion, you can try out for different data to be transmitted. I will just try to stop the debugger. Let me send the message continuously. Within this while loop, such a way that, let me save it, build it again. Now I will be seeing the message being sent serially continuously in an unended loop. Let me start the debugger. I can see the memory windows and the UART windows. Let me now first check UART 1. Run the code. Go to serial window. Check the output. So I can see the serially the data transfer is happening, and also this continuous transfer of the data. So you can see, scroll down, and unless and until you are going to give an exit to this loop, the message is being transferred continuously. Thank you for watching.